Hello, I'm Dr. Betsy Greene from the University of Vermont, the Equine Extension Specialist, and also a member of the eXtension horse community of practice. Do you know how you would prevent a sick horse from infecting all the others in your barn? So, first thing you need to know is how diseases are transmitted in order to protect the other horses. First thing, you have direct transmission, so that disease could be passed from inhalation or breathing, ingestion or eating, direct contact, touching, getting disease into either an open wound or mucous membrane, or even a bite wound, direct bite wound, for example, with rabies. Another method of transmission is indirect transmission. So that would include something like an insect vector, a biting insect, infecting an animal or human, and also a fomite. A fomite is actually an inanimate object that has been contaminated. So for example, taking a towel that's been contaminated and then using it on another horse. So now that you know how the diseases can be transmitted, what would you do if you had a sick horse in your barn? First things first, you want to isolate that horse. The ideal situation would be is if you can keep that horse completely away from other horse and human traffic. A lot of times people can't do that, so if you can find the stall that has the least traffic, and maybe that's a back stall, and maybe even rope off that stall so that horses and other humans will not be passing through and potentially transmitting disease for you. So you as the person treating that animal or caring for them, you can do several things to decrease potential of disease passing. If you are the key person that's taking care of that sick horse, you can do several things to limit disease transmission. So first of all, do not share equipment. That's brushes, water buckets, feed tubs, or any other type of wheelbarrows, pitchforks, or things like that. Treat that sick animal last, or care for that sick animal last, after you've taken care of the healthy horses. You can also use protective clothing, gloves, or even booties. After you've handled the animal, make sure that you wash your hands well with soap and water or use some sort of disinfectant. Now, after the animal has returned to health, you need to thoroughly clean all equipment and the stall, removing organic matter and then disinfecting properly to make sure that other horses in the stall using that equipment are not infected later. Now, you need to also protect yourself, because some diseases are zoonotic, and that means that horse can actually transmit that disease to a human. Some of those types of diseases range from salmonella, ringworm, and even rabies. For more information on horses and their diseases, go to www.extension.org/horses.